Good morning. My name is Danny Garrett with the Washington Department of Fish and Wildlife, and I'm joined today by Scott Imholt and Craig Dowdy of YJ Guide Services. And they've graciously offered up their time today to teach us a few things about catching burbot here in the Spokane arm of Lake Roosevelt. A recent survey conducted by the Department of Fish and Wildlife indicates that only 2% of Washington license holders actually fish for burbot, but hopefully we'll change that today. Burbot are native to Washington and found in 11 deep lakes throughout the Columbia River system, though few people have laid eyes on these fish. Hopefully, with Scott and Craig's help today, we can take a look at a burbot and introduce you to catching these cool-looking fish.
Another one up front. First double of the day. That's a good thing. Oh yeah, Craig's got a nice one up front. Look at there, that's how it's supposed to be. Two at a time.
Or burbot right there. Look at that. That is a neat looking fish. Wow.
We're going to take a little break from fishing here and talk with Scott about what we're doing today. Scott, why don't you tell the folks at home what type of rod we're using and what type of lure and bait we're using today.
We like to use a 6'6", 7-foot medium action spinning rod, open face reels, braid, and just your regular jig head with a plastic skirt on it, tip it with a piece of worm.
And then how do you like to generally work these baits during the month of December?
Send it right down to the bottom, yeah, and jig it. Not over aggressively, but give a little bit of movement and they stay pretty close to the bottom. So over jig it and you'll pop it out of the fish range.
So less is more then?
Less is more.
So a lot of people have told me varying things about how these things are to eat. What's your experience eating burbot?
They're excellent eating. We like to fillet them, cut them into chunks, put them in a frying pan with butter and garlic. Tastes just like lobster. Poor man lobster.
All right, I'm on. Yeah. Got one on. Hopefully it's a burbot. Feels like it probably is from what I've been seeing. There we go. Nice. All right, nice burbot. Nice to get another one of these. A lot of fun. Cool looking fish.
All right, Craig's hooked up on another fish here. Looks like a walleye. Well, that's not what we're after today, but that's a nice fish. They are pretty. Whoa, all right, we hooked into what I think is a nice burbot here. Just dragging it real slow along the bottom, and that time I felt him hit it, just a thunk as he sucked the bait in. Oh yeah, this is a good fish here. Oh, I need to loosen the drag here. Nice fish.
Oh yeah, that's the size we're looking for.
All right. Nicely done. That's what we're looking for. That's a dandy. All right, nice burbot here. We'll hold him up so you can get a good look at him. Beautiful colors on these fish. Nothing else quite looks like a burbot. Fantastic. So let's take a closer look at a burbot. You can see that burbot do not resemble other freshwater fish species in Washington. And in fact, burbot are the only freshwater member of the cod family. And like their cousins, the Pacific cod, they have a single barbel coming off their chin. They also have these large flattened heads and these large pectoral fins on their side, which are morphological characteristics that tell us that these fish live right on the bottom. They also have an elongate body and a small tail, which doesn't make them particularly strong or fast swimmers, but it does allow them to reduce drag as they swim in the current along the bottom, actively seeking food like crayfish and sculpin. Now, research on burbot tells us these fish do have a tendency to move more at night in search of food, but as you've seen today, they can be caught during the early morning hours as well. Another burbot hooked up here, late morning, right on the bottom. Nice fish. They're so pretty in the water. All right, there's another one. Beautiful.
Yeah.
Another nice burbot. You can see he ate that jig. Excellent. So thanks so much for joining us, and we hope that you'll get out and explore the far corners of the state of Washington in search of interesting fish like burbot. Remember, winter time is a dangerous time, so make sure you dress for the conditions and wear your life jacket at all times. For Craig Dowdy, Scott Imholt of YJ Guide Services, and myself, we'd like to thank you for watching. Have a great winter fishing season and a great time fishing Washington.